include, recall when we went to Ureko, and there was this issue of military brutality there.
Yes.
The ones attached to Presco, allegedly attached to Presco PLC. And you mentioned of getting the boundary commission into it. I don't know how far.
Absolutely. Actually, that matter also came before my committee. Where I said the Committee on Ethics, Privileges and Public Petitions. I raised a petition on behalf of the people of Ureku in Ethiopia's local government area on this very matter. Coincidentally, my own father, most people don't even understand this, my own dad, my late dad of blessed memory, was actually born that Ureku in Ethiopia. So I'm a stakeholder right there in all that is happening out there. So this matter has now come before my committee. As I speak to you right now, we are working on a list of witnesses to be called. Of course, you got that right. The Boundary Commission is going to be one of the people to be called to testify beyond the committee stakeholders and press school and what have you. But I think the major witness that we are seeking to bring in there, beyond the ones I've mentioned and beyond the military, because the military, as far as I'm concerned, overstepped their bounds, right, and aligned themselves to be used to brutalize our mothers and sisters who reside in that very community. But more important than all of them is the Boundary Commission. They need to come in with their documentations to tell us where that property, you know, falls into. If it falls into Delta State, of course, Presco will have to come to the table to discuss as tenants. If it falls in Edo State, then of course, you know, we will not become the tenants. Those are the issues we're looking at right now. But yes, any minute from now, I'm sure once we resume from recess, that matter will be taken up.
While some are calling Ecomium that you're doing so well, others are of the opinion that some of your projects are not cutting across, while some are benefiting more, others are not. So, sir, would you say you have really allowed your projects to go round?
Absolutely. Those who are saying so are speaking out of ignorance. They don't know what we have done. They don't know what projects we've put in the budget. Of course, there will always be some too, right, who are natural detractors. They will continue to make those kind of allegations. But I can assure you that all the projects we've cited, we've provided for in the budget, you know, they're cut across the 8 local government area. We're any moment from now, we're going to be holding our first constituency briefing, where I will brief the Urhobo Nation of my stewardship in the Senate in the past 1 year and 5 months. Because people are celebrating 2 years. Now I'm actually celebrating only 1 year and 5 months because everyone knows what happened. That 7 months of my tenure, of my mandate given to me by the Urhobo people, was stolen, you know, by the electoral thieves. You get it right there. That's why I'm celebrating only a year and 5 months. So we go in there, I'll render account of all of the bills that I've pushed and passed, all of the motions I have pushed and passed, all of the petitions that I've raised and passed. And I will go into all of the projects that we've attracted to each local government area of the 8 local governments. And there are so many. I don't want to prejudge by naming them right now, but if I must, you know, the biggest one, like I said, it's the Amukbe, Sapele, Eku, Abraka to Agbo. Now, in the interest of fairness and fair disclosure, let me say this. I did not put that road in the budget, but I caused that road to be funded. That road has been in the budget since time immemorial. I think as far back as 2008 or thereabout, you know, I believe my colleague and my brother at the time, who served in the House of Reps, Honorable Agoda, I'm sure was probably the one right there who fought to get to include the budget. But it's one thing to include a project in the budget and another thing to have it funded. Even in this current budget now, as we speak, in 2017 budget, in my capacity as a member of the Committee on Appropriations, I have caused 5 billion in addition to what the ministry has brought to be included in that project to facilitate and expedite its completion. Now, I say this as a flagship because this project cuts across Sapele local government, Okbe local government, my own Ugele North, and Ethiopia. This is four local governments. Now, in addition to causing this project to be funded, I also saw to it that the company, the contractor, that is to handle this project, I insisted that they also come and site their corporate headquarters here in Roboland. And you know what that means, with the opportunity that it brings to create job opportunities, you know, for our jobless youth within that corridor. And I'm seeing to it that it's only people within that corridor, that is the corridor of Okpe, Sapele, Ethiopist, and Ugeli North, that are the people who will benefit not just from the employment opportunities, but also the contracting opportunities like supply of sand, supply of diesel, supply of asphalt, you just name it. Everything that is connected to that project, the benefits will come to our jobless youths within that period. You cannot put a premium on that. Moving from there, you talk about consulting projects, we have regional water schemes that I've cited in Ugeli North, I've cited in Ethiopia East. We're citing the same thing now in Alaja, Iludu, Oruweru, Iludu, Iwu in Ugeli South. The other year, we're moving to Sapele, and we're moving to Jesse. You know, so if you look at, just talking about that, the regional water schemes, I'm not even talking about electricity or street lighting or just name it. There's so much, I would rather wait until we go for the consultancy briefing and then release everything. But our people can rest assured that every part of Roboland that I represent right there are adequately captured in the 2017 budget.